Hello everyone, welcome to Infigon Talks. My name is Ramani Desai and I will be the host for today's interview. Infigon Talks is a part of Infigon Futures flagship program where mentors from various institutes motivate and inspire aspiring students across the country. Today, Mr. Aniruddhan Ganesaraman, he's currently pursuing BSc in Mathematics and Computer Science from Chennai Mathematical Institute. He was awarded third prize in the Space Settlement Contest conducted by the National Space Society in collaboration with NASA AMES Research Center. Apart from being an NTSC scholar and KYPI fellow, he has also bagged a national level and three state level awards in Abacus. Mr. Aniruddhan has also presented his project at the International Space Development Conference in Toronto, Canada. Hello, Mr. Aniruddhan. Welcome to Infigon Talks.
Hi, Ramani. Thank you very much, both Ramani and team, for having me.
Surely. So, first of all, as you're a student of Chennai Institute of Chennai Mathematical Institute, so which I have heard is very tough to get into. So can you tell us how is life at CMI pre-pandemic, of course?
Oh, I would love to. Thanks for the question. So I think start with a little bit of an anecdote. So I was an early bird in my high school, right from grade 6 all the way until 12. I was a very early bird, going to bed by 9 o'clock and waking up at 6 a.m. because college in the later part of my high school used to start at 6:30. And so now, thanks to CMI, I'm now a night owl, going to bed anywhere from 11:30 p.m. to 3 a.m. So I have no schedule. And so that's mainly because of the amazing peers in the hostel we have. So it's forever filled with enthusiasm in the hostel. And to add to that, we have a night canteen, which runs from 10 p.m. to 2 a.m., where we get Maggi, cold coffee, and any of the delicacies you want. And that motivates us to stay awake. And apart from that, like, it's there's also a very vibrant atmosphere for both studying as well as enjoyment. So we have amazing profs who are extremely approachable, not just for subject related queries, but also for just about any motivation or anything, any advice you want. So we have an amazing set of profs, and not to forget the excellent peer groups we have, ranging from our own batchmates to both the seniors and juniors. So they're excellent at advice and they're always there to hold you back. And finally, I think there are malls. I should mention that there are two malls nearby to hang out, go watch movies and anything there. And excellent food stores all on the way. And so there's one particular place by the name of Favorite Spot, which opens at 4 a.m. So you can see a couple of CMI students queuing up at 4 a.m. to have their dinner and then go to sleep. And that's how it is. And apart from that, there are like plenty of activities in CMA as well. So you have your football court, you have badminton, you have volleyball, TT, chess, and a mini gym, etc. And apart from that, you also have plenty of activities to do on campus. So we have a very own college fest of ours. It's an annual fest. It's called Tessellate. So there we have food stalls again. Most importantly, I should start with that, and concerts and chess events, cubing events, and many more. So it's just a whole lot of people getting together. And finally, CMI's passion for music is forever known. So there's a lot of music also going on there. So that's a small glimpse into what life in CMI is.
That sounds really interesting. And definitely, you know, a college is much more than an academic curriculum. It's so much more, so many memories, so many friends, and as you said, so much hangout places. So yeah, absolutely. Definitely. Apart from the college, pursuing BSc in Mathematics and Computer Science, so what got you interested in maths? Because it's such a curious subject to be interested in.
I get that question very often. So I really do not have a concrete answer to this, but what I believe got me interested in math was, as you mentioned, so I graduated Abacus when I was in grade 5. So that is kind of something like to help train your mind for mental math. So to do calculations and addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and sometimes even to the extent of square root, and all on your head. So that's something like which got me playing with numbers from a very early age. So I was in Abacus from grade one and graduated it in grade five. So it has like about 10 levels, if I remember correctly. Oh. And so a shout out here to my teacher, Mrs. Prabha Prasad. So she was extremely pivotal in making me realize my passions for math. And then that naturally carried on to my high school teacher, where Mr. Giri, he was extremely instrumental in once again, I'd say like encouraging my interest and forever being there to give me new problems to think about and things like that. So, and my principal, of course, who was forever, so I was in a JEE school. I was in Sri Chaitanya Techno School, which was majorly training students for JEE. So even there, the principal, even though the principal there knew that I wanted to do math, so he still kept me motivating and pushed me to do math. And that's what got me there. And finally, like there are like many more other discrete yet small events which got me more and more interested in math.
That's amazing. Your passion for mathematics also surely reflects on all your achievements that you have. So yeah, definitely. But also there is a stereotype that an average student, you know, grows up hating the subject mathematics. So we actually are not aware. Why is it? Because if it's because of the education system or the way mathematics is taught in schools and colleges. So what is your perspective on how mathematics should be taught in schools and colleges? Is it right what the current education system is pursuing, or do you have other thoughts about it?
Oh, so I don't have a rule book per se, but at least in my opinion, majority of the schools now, they follow some sort of like a formula-based curriculum for math. So math is typically usually like a list of formulas which you have to by heart and do it do by this process to get things right. And in my opinion, that's not how math should be seen as. So a key part of at least a career in math in a very early on stage, like from your high school on, is you should be able to get a necessary intuition for what you're doing. That's something which I find not too prevalent in the current high school scenarios. So maybe to the bit more mathematically matured audience here, so maybe it may not make entire sense to do an entire course in point set topology without having done a course in real analysis. And like there are always like these seemingly strange definitions of determinants of a matrix. So things like these, I think, should be motivated for why it is being done so or how it originated. So that, I think, is one key point which seems to be missing, at least in what I know of. And so, but nevertheless, there are like plenty of YouTube channels or other speakers who are doing an extremely commendable job in setting this right, if I may call so. So channels like 3Blue1Brown and Number5. So they do an excellent job in giving you the necessary intuition behind these weird looking math concepts. So that's something which I really like. So, and one more thing which I find not disturbing per se, but which I think can be done better, is that students should be given time to absorb the material instead of simply rote learning. So they shouldn't be just made to by heart formulas, like I said earlier, and just apply the formulas or vomit out the formulas. That is something which shouldn't be done. So these are some things which I would say would be necessary to have a change.
Yeah, definitely. Even as it said, that maths is not a concept to learn. It's something which you acquire. That's so rightly said what you did to put in into a small sentence.
Absolutely. Math is a language.
Yes, definitely. So you have been a National Talent Search Examination Scholar as well and a KYPI member as well. So you have won many awards in Abacus, as you mentioned before. So which shows your experience in competitive examination, and that is really impressive. So I would like to ask you, as of today, exams that you mentioned are conducted in a specific time limit. So do you think maths is a subject that is supposed to be time bound?
That's a tricky question to answer. So I'd say the answer to that is both yes and no. So I'll just elaborate a bit on why yes and why no. I'd say yes because having a time bound will kind of help you get a command over clarity. Like to connect the dots, you need to be able to immediately do it at some times. So having a time bound will kind of help you to get something like a command over whatever ideas which are waving around in your head. And that I think I would stop there with yes. And I would majorly tilt towards no, because students, in my opinion, should be given enough time to firstly think about the problem. And as I said, develop an intuition for what they're doing. And secondly, one more thing which is important, which I feel, is that students should also be allowed to make slight tweaks to the problem. So for instance, if a problem has like a list of A, B, C hypotheses, and the question asks to prove something. So a student should have time to think about what happens if I remove hypothesis B, or what goes wrong if I try to generalize this a little bit more. So things like these, in my opinion, students should be given a little bit time to think about. So what happens in a time-bound exam is that we think of one way, just vomit it out on the paper and move on to the next one. So I'd kind of say a balance between a yes and no here, with slightly tilting towards a no.
Yeah, definitely. As I said, maths is a language, definitely, because it's not something you learn and in exam you just, you know, vomit out whatever you have learned. It's something much more than that. It's a mathematician is an artist. He should be given his creative time.
Absolutely.
To create wonders. Yeah. So, yeah. So apart from the career in mathematics, you've also spearheaded some major events in your colleges. So such as, how was your experience at that? Because how you started hosting these events? You've also taken a part in your project that you presented at ISDC, that is International Space Development Conference in Toronto. So how was your experience in that as well? So yeah, any insights you would like to provide?
Oh, sure. I think I'll answer this question in two parts. Firstly, about the ISDS, and secondly, about hosting this college event. So so the International Space Development Conference, this was, I think, at the end of my eighth grade, where one of my physics teachers, during physics classes, we have a lot of fun interaction and not just discuss about the physics, which is to be done for JEE. So we have a lot of interaction which goes on. We watch movies in the class, and there are things like that which go on. This was back in eighth grade. So back then, we had like a small student group, and one of our physics teachers reached out saying, "Hey, this is something which I read today. Like, would you like to be a part of it?" And we said, "Yeah, sure, we'd love to be a part of it." And so what we had to do was to kind of prepare a report on space settlement contests. So what if someday the Earth was to be uninhabitable, or if in some sense, if what other alternate options do we have? So that was the objective in mind. So with that in mind, we proposed some sort of a prototype for what you could do to settle outside. So what are the major challenges you should think of, and how do you overcome them? So this was like the essence of the project. And so this led us to presenting this project at the IISDC in Toronto in, I think, 2016, if I remember correctly. So there we had, that was one of the best moments of my life, where we had interactions with astronauts and scientists. And I actually got to hold in my hand a piece of a meteorite. So these were things So these were things which I really enjoyed. And coming to the second part of your question about spearheading events, I think I really love talking to people. So hosting events is something which will naturally lead you to make these amazing set of contacts. So that's what got me into starting to host events. So once again, going back to my high school, so when my vice principal gave me the responsibility just out of the blue to organize a farewell for the outgoing 10th graders when I was in my 9th grade. And that luckily turned out well. And that's what actually gave me a little bit of a teeny tiny confidence that I could do something like this. And coming to CMI, that's where I started to organize such events more or less from the very ground. So I was the coordinator of STEMS, which is the Scholastic Test of Excellence in Mathematical Sciences, and TESOLATE, which is the annual college fest of CMI, for 2 years. So I was the coordinator for this for 2 years. And so these are like some things which I've organized. And secondly, CMI, as I told you, has a knack for music. So on 30th of December last year, so we kicked off 2020 by organizing a music fest, wherein we had people, professors, students, alumni, and both academic and non-academic staff participating in the music evening. So what we thought would be a 2-hour event extended all the way to 4 hours. So,
So that's really nice, I see. And as you said, that CMI has this a great eternal love for music. So are you into music? Do you like to sing, or maybe some hidden hobby that you have?
Firstly, I think you do not want me to listen. You do not want to listen to me sing, so I can hear. So I do not have any specific taste. So just about any nice music I listen to.
That's amazing. So lastly, my question for you is, what advice would you like to give students who desire to pursue their career in the field of mathematics or computer science?
Oh, okay. Advice, okay. I'd say firstly, okay, this may be biased since it's coming from me. So I'd say just talk to more people. Don't stick to one or two people's advice. And so just remember that every story is different and take everything with a pinch of salt. So you guys, Infigon is in fact doing an excellent job in connecting people. So get connected with people specifically like alumni and profs or students of your dream college. Talk to them and get an first-hand experience of how things are. And maybe like I'd say, like, don't be afraid to explore anything. So whatever challenge comes in the way, make sure you put it in your bag and do face it. And don't restrict to one particular area. That's really one thing which I would like to iterate. And finally, like, there is no rule book for success. So whatever you do, it's something which has to stick with you. So do what you think is best and do not repent, because you took the best decision given those circumstances. You should not say, I should have done this back. And just convince yourself that you would have taken the best decision in that particular circumstance. And accept the fact that everybody makes mistakes and things will change. So, and finally, maybe I'd say explore every possible options you've got. Explore Twitter, explore YouTube. So there are tons of opportunities out there. And so I think I'll just end by just one of the favorite quotes. When anybody asks for advice, I just say, don't listen to any advice if they say that's the only route. So things will fall into place when they have to. And don't worry about things which aren't in your control.
That's amazing. That is the words that are come from you. So yeah, it was an honor to have you on our talk show. So yeah, here we conclude our interview, Mr. Aniruddhan. And for the viewers, you know the drill, like, share, and subscribe to Infigon Futures.